In this lesson, we will add some sounds to our game. So let's get started. Let's open Visual Studio Code. Next step would be to start the Pyxel Resource Editor. Open Sounds Editor by clicking here. Sound Editor looks very similar to MIDI music editors. To the left there is a piano roll, which you can use to write some music. It is also used for creating sounds. Click on the piano roll canvas and hold mouse button to draw something like this. Set speed to 1. The name speed here is misleading. If you increase the speed, the sound will actually be slower. Life hack: hold shift and click to decrease speed by 10 instead of 1. I think this sounds perfect. Save the resource file and close the resource editor window. Let's get back to coding. But before that, if you find this video useful, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. This allows me to help more people and also helps me to stay motivated to make more videos. We need to change the player class. When we detect the collision with the wall, we are going to play sound. So we need to change the code here. To play sound, we use play function. It takes 4 parameters: number of sound, 0 in our case. In total, there may be 64 sounds. Number of channel to play sound to. Only 4 sounds can be played at the same time, so the channels are from 0 to 3. And 2 optional parameters that we will ignore for now. Let's create a new model, Pyxel Utils. Here we will add a method that we will call to play sound. Let's check if it works. So I go left and I hit the wall and I hear a lot of sounds. Each frame when I hit the wall, I will start playing the new sound and I have 60 frames per second. It could be fine if that's what I want. But what if I want to play sound only once when I hit the wall? We can do this by creating a class with a state that checks when was the last time we started playing hit the wall sound. In this particular case, I will use Pyxel frame counter. I will check that there was at least 60 frames from the last time I played sound before I play it again. Let's make appropriate changes to our player class. And now let's test it. Perfect, the sound is played only once. In similar way, I can change all the other moving methods, but I will do some refactoring to simplify my life. I will refactor move right and move left to the common method move horizontally. This method will take dx as a parameter, which could be either -1 or 1. -1 would make us move left, and 1 would make us move right. Let's test the changes. works perfectly. Next step would be to refactor move up and move down into move vertically, but I will let you do it on your own. By the way, if you want to check the complete code for this lesson, there will be a link in the description for the GitHub repository where you can find it. That's it for today's lesson. In the next lesson, we will add some very basic music to our game, so stay tuned.